pretty on the verge of maybe not getting first place in their group with the loss to TMSR. To fall all the way to, say, a third place, I mean, that would be something for Lion Esports Club. So again, it's I don't think it's a knockout game necessarily, but at the same time, starting 0-2 would also be really devastating to the morale. I mean, they were bummed after that TMSR loss, as they should have been. I mean, obviously, they feel like they're a great team coming in. They're confident coming in. We had an interview with Hanskin after the Cycle 7. He feels like Lion Esports Club is a team to beat coming in because of their recent victories and whatnot. But starting off with a loss, that has got to sting a little bit, Beef. And here they are. They're going to be looking for some revenge. Let's jump into the game. Lions versus the Ringers. So again, you're looking at the lineups. By the way, the Ringers, you see what they finished with? They go with the Puppet Master here.
Yeah.
For Archie Tiger. So he's going to play the Carry Puppet. They also picked up a Prisoner on top of that by Saint Rocks. It's been a while since we've seen Prisoner, honestly.
It has. He was the hero that came onto the scene, and everybody's like, oh, this is the best hero ever. Nerf, 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 nerf.
Yeah.
And then he got hit with, like, some smaller nerfs.
Not everyone, to be fair.
I mean,
just
Breaky.
A couple of select
I think
few.
Breaky was, like, the only person that's like, guys, let's give this some time.
Yeah.
Not hit him with a nerf bat right away. He got hit with, like, some smaller nerfs. And then now he's just, like, almost gone from the scene. Like, less than one every 10 games, you're going to see a Prisoner on average. And so, I mean, he's definitely a strong hero, but some of the heroes that he was trying to set up to counter, maybe dropping off a little bit there as well. In any case, got the Prisoner, got the Puppet Master, along with Kraken Tempest and Master of Arms. So it's going to be really interesting to see how the Ringers choose to set this one up. And I think we're actually going to be probably seeing that Puppet Master babysit somebody. But at the same time, no, it's actually Archetiger. He's on their carry. And what am I talking about? Because he's got that Ring of the Teacher as well. But Breaky, I'm excited to get into this match.
Yeah, he's going
to
be up here at the short lane, so definitely Prisoner, Master of Arms middle. You got Kraken, going to be going suicide. Tempest in the jungle is what it comes down to. As far as Lion Esports Club, Jonas Fan on Valkyrie playing the Suicide Valkyrie. Once again, this guy, just like Keizu was for quite a while, especially when he was playing for State Grand, you know, he was popping up with Suicide Heroes. Scout, Magmus came out of nowhere with him. I mean, obviously a very strong Wild Soul player, but yeah, my point being, you know, he's doing this kind of different heroes that others weren't. Jonas Fan's kind of filling that role now. The Grinnix, obviously, and now, of course, the Valkyrie that he's bringing back. So, and I love seeing it. Talk about a staple hero, man, in the competitive scene. Yeah. I mean, the Valkyrie just feels like a hero that needs to be played. The Javelin, or as a lot of people call it, the Arrow, is such a fun ability to watch for. And obviously in good hands, such as Jonas Fan, it makes for that. Look what Lions is doing, though. They send Torture to the top to really lock down Puppet Master. This means Pestilence is going to solo, but I think this has a lot to do with, well, they figure they're not going to win this middle lane anyways, so let's just lock down Puppet Master.
Yeah, putting the Torture there in the middle lane would almost be a tantamount to feeding him. I mean, you get hit by one hook and that charge shot's an easy setup, you're going to die. And making sure to try to use him in one of these other lanes, trying to lock down the Puppet Master, I like the decision here from Lions. So KGE definitely not going to have the easiest time here in the middle lanes, but he'll get some farm, he'll get some levels, and that's really all you need. Allow him to recover at, say, 5 minutes, 6 minutes into the game.
Yeah.
He'll still get that portal key at a pretty decent time. He'll still be effective. So good choice coming out of the Lions right now. The bottom lane's the one I'm looking at here. Kraken and Slither squaring off against one another. And Slither is one of these heroes like a Corrupted Disciple. People say you always win your lane with this Slither. But Kraken with some stacked regen, I mean, he's definitely a strong hero in his own right. But Fousey already pounding those auto attacks.
I was going to say, you just look at that, though. The toxicity debuff is just so annoying to deal against. And, you know, being a melee hero himself, he has to get in there for those auto attacks to kill the creeps. So he's easily putting himself in range of the auto attacks from Slither, who's only a 500 range hero. So, you know, he's weaker than others. But still, you know, again, being the melee hero that he's going up against, he's able to harass Book quite a bit. Playing the Kraken. So, it's not no surprise to see Fousey doing a pretty damn good job down there. He also has Ophelia in the jungle, so that's another thing Kraken is going to have to be a little worried about in terms of what he's doing down here. He used his health potion. He's now just down to trees, and that life is continuing to tick down. Look at Pestilence in the middle in the meantime. He actually had an invis. He actually used a hatchet out of the invis to kill one of the creeps right there. Again, goes to show you just how much he is struggling, but at the same time, he's 7-0, so managing at least a decent amount of creep farm. Granted, Prisoner is 15-2. Now 16-2 even in that middle matchup. So again, as expected, having a good time. But also at the top lane then, Jonas the Phantom Valkyrie, 10-6 creep farm now. Puppet Master only 2-0. So it's safe to say this whole idea of locking down the Puppet Master is being accomplished so far by Lion Esports Club.
Yeah, certainly is. But, I mean, their other lanes, they're going all right. Like you'd said, I mean, Prisoner getting the farm. But KG, as long as he's getting levels, and, I mean, past that, any amount of farm is really going to be helping. Right now, he doesn't really need that farm terribly. If he can get boots, if he can get a bottle, that's going to be fantastic. But yeah, he's getting his job done, and we'll see when he starts roaming. That's when he's going to be picking up some kills, and then he can probably have one of the open lanes. And then you got your junglers matching up here as well. Looks like Papa Male, he hasn't missed too much from when he was back as one of the top junglers here on Tempest. He's still getting the job done. Hanskin on the other side, doing well, but middle lane breaky.
Oh, Pestilence in some trouble. He cannot use this flight with the shackles. It is going to wear off, though. He got the impel sent off. He is going to be fine. So obviously, again, that is worth noting once again. He cannot use the flight when he's in those shackles, and that kind of showed right there. But the impel easily lives. He's going to be fine. In fact, going for the top runner. I will say that was good execution between Snooey and Saint Rocks right there. The stun on top. And actually, he'll stun Pestilence to pick up the refreshment room. But uh-oh, that might come at a cost. Yeah. Nope, he's going to be fine.
Gets the assistance from his teammate over there. Just even showing the movement up toward the top river means that Prisoner could have been in range for a hook. So don't want to be getting too crazy right there. Yeah. Otherwise, that could have been a very dead bug for the Legion team. But nope, he's going to be all right. Back into this top lane. Puppet Master is hugging his tower breaky. I mean, he's having a really rough time up here. Like you said, being zoned out, still at 3-0 CS. And Valkyrie's got a ton. She's going to actually go for the Steam Boots rather than something like the Ghost Marches that we've seen sometimes.
Yeah.
So this is going to allow her to get more mana to both spam her spells as well as get those javelins out, throw those for the stuns. And we'll see if Jonas is going to be doing a little bit more roaming, getting more active. or not, as that was a pretty close arrow.
Yeah, well, they were setting that up for a while right there. You do see Torture again. It's only the level one changer, or it's the level two, excuse me, but still, just not long enough to help set up the arrow from Valkyrie. So they were setting it up for a while, but in the end, Valkyrie is still doing very good when it comes to the creep farm. Over 300 GPM now. You look at Prisoner, though. Prisoner is leading the charts by quite a bit, 350 gold per minute. And as you mentioned, Papa Male on Tempest, he's off to a solid start as well, 270. Working towards that Ring of Sorcery. In fact, 1,400 plus gold saved up. So that very likely is going to be coming out here very shortly. But going back to the middle, though, again, Prisoner going at it with the Pestilence. Going to kind of go back and forth. But yeah, Puppet Master having this slower start. I mean, it always goes back to the tough case. You see an arrow randomly going to be used right there. What is this build going to be like now? I mean, again, the Whispering Helm seems like it's a really strong go-to item on Puppet Master, and I still would not be surprised to see that by any means, but it's going to be a lot later of a Whispering Helm, and it's not necessarily the most effective in terms of team fighting. And I feel like Lion Esports Club, as they usually do, they made a team that's going to be looking to play pretty aggressive in the earlier on states. So Puppet Master might find himself in a very troublesome place now as this game picks up.
Yeah, Puppet's one of these heroes that's kind of like a Dampier that you got to get started early. Otherwise, they're not necessarily going to get kicked off. And I mean, even more so to an extent than where Dampier is. So right now, like you said, going to be really interesting to see that build. I don't think that a Whispering Helm is going to be the best option here, because if you're really restricted to 100 gold per minute Puppet Master, even at 10 or 12 minutes in, he's probably not going to be carrying too effectively, at least until the hyper late game.
Yeah.
And I don't know, maybe just going for something like that, Assassin Shroud right away, trying to get a little bit more active could be interesting. But at least right now, Lions are already establishing a very solid resource advantage for themselves. Only 6 minutes in, Ophelia continuing to do all right, but it's mostly Fousey and Jonas, I'm fan, that are dictating the pace in these top and bottom lanes.
Well, you do see the ringers. Yeah, they're trying to set something up at the top lane. Meanwhile, middle lane, Pestilence gets pulled in, actually. Shackles apply, but it was applied after he got the flight off. And Prisoner's not going to be able to chase him down. He's going for it. He has bottle charges, actually. He can land another hook, but no, it's not even going to come close. Bottom tower going down in the meantime. Ophelia and Slither, easy push for them. Kraken happened to not be there. He is level 6, but yeah, he was actually back at base doing some regen, most likely. So not able to come through there. I was going to say Prisoner, he wasn't level 6 either. If he was level 6, that very likely could have been a dead Pestilence, actually. So trying to give Super KG a taste of his own medicine, but back to the bottom lane. Kraken's in trouble. The poison bursting. It turns around the turret. They release the Kraken. Trying to help for a turn kill. They might get one. Tempest, he's charging in, as well as basically everyone else. He has an ultimate. He doesn't want to use it if he doesn't have to. He's going to use it. Minotaur cannot get close enough. He's going to send it right there. He tries to turn it. The Ophelia's touch. He keeps Slither alive, and he's going to turn it on to Tempest. No! Tempest barely survives. There's the auto attack. He will go down. He does fall, though. they're trying to chase now with Slither. The auto attacks. It is going to kill Master of Arms. The Puppet Master also, though. No, he's out of range.
Oh my god.
Are you kidding me? Puppet Master, he cannot be killed with the Puppet Shell, but he will die to the dot. What a turnaround for Lion Esports Club.
Oh my god, Breaky. I was watching him set that up, and I'm like, okay, Ophelia has the ultimate right here. Are they actually going to try for this? Tempest Ult goes off right there. She holds it out, waits for them to get out of position, and Slither hits a gigantic poison spray. Huge turnaround right there for the Lions.
Yeah.
Three kills, and just like that, we're at 5,000 gold, 2,000 experience advantage. And Lions, they're definitely rolling in this one. They're saying, guys, we are not going to 0-2. This is not a thing that's happening. And so they get some big kills right there. They're going to be able to continue exerting pressure top. Jonas and Fan at 380 gold per minute there in the top lane.
Yeah.
It's going to be even higher as soon as they take down this tower.
Yeah, and I'm definitely curious to see what kind of build Fuzi goes for. I know he tends to go more the Icon of the Goddess build, and I think this game would definitely speak for that plenty as well. I mean, they're clearly off to a great start. Why not just continue to work off that momentum? Possibly finish off the Energizer first, obviously, as he's sitting on the Soul Scream Ring, but go from the Icon for there again. Well, so we'll wait and see what Fuzi goes for. But yeah, his GPM specifically definitely going up right there. You mentioned Jonas the Fan. They're pushing this top tower. They're going to go for Puppet Master. Chain Reactions hit. Arrow's not going to be used. Not even necessary, though. Pestilence coming in. The Call of the Valkyrie more than enough. Kraken's here. He has a release in 3 seconds. Ooh. You see the hook's going to miss from Prisoner. Nice deny on the tower release. But at what cost here for Saint Rock? Still hanging around. Valkyrie putting in the auto attacks. And it will be enough to kind of fall back from one another. So Saint Rock's making some big plays right there once again and able to deny the tower at least. And it ain't over just yet, Beef.
Yeah, making some plays right there, and Prisoner gonna go for the hook, trying for it, not gonna happen though, and there's the Prison Break gonna be a play on top of the Kraken ultimate, dragged him right back in, and now it looks like Valkyrie and Torture trying to run, but Val gets blocked out right here. She's gonna take a lot of damage. Torrent Flow is applied. She's gonna hit the health potion, trying to bring around the Rosie here. I don't see her getting out of this. No way, no how. Although Torture in the background trying to help out, but now Seal Kid is gonna go down as well. Shackle being applied, Breaky, and that's gonna be yet another kill, maybe. Poison Burst from Slither coming in though, and now it looks like Slither's gonna try to pick up at least one or two here. Tempest as well as Prisoner will drop, and it looks like Master of Arms maybe as well. Yes, MOA should go down, but Slither going to fall. Geez.
Wow, that was a big fight for the Ringers. I mean, the fact that it ended like that, they kill Fuzi. Yeah, I mean, I thought that there was definitely a big chance for turnaround there for Lion Esports Club, but clearly just not nearly enough damage. I mean, Fuzi got a good poison burst off. They got the initial kill to Tempest, and obviously Prisoner dying before that, but Master of Arms actually able to live, but then Kraken and Puppet Master able to hold their ground. But now while that was happening, Ophelia was pushing the bottom lane when that was all taking place. So she actually pushed in a secondary tower. So the overall, again, you see the gold lead is actually still very similar to where it was when that fight really began. It's around a 6,300 gold lead as well as the 1,100 experience lead here. So just I think that's really that biggest factor of that really didn't go too bad for Lion Esports Club in the end. But still, they do definitely, or at least the Hellboar team does a pretty good job time, or pretty good time in the middle lane. They pull in Torture in the meantime, and Pillstone misses actually. It was used it a little too early, but Puppet Master taking the lockdown from Ophelia will fall. The Tempest ultimate lockdown Pestilence. No follow up though. In the meantime, Prisoner does kill Torturer, but not nearly enough to make it well fought for his team, and that's going to be a mid tower kill in the end. So, Lion Esports Club, once again, they have the better of the exchange in the end.
Yeah, and they're going to go ahead and convert that into the tier one. Maybe even the tier 2 right here with Slither and the level 3 Toxin Wards. I think they have a very good chance, actually. Unfortunately, KG doesn't have a portal key just yet, so not going to be able to get in there for any additional initiation, but easy tower, and just like that, Lions up to 10,000 gold lead just 12 minutes in, Breaky. And I mean, the Ringers, they looked good against the Law. Lions, they're on a bit of a different level.
Yeah. Well, and again, I think a lot of it does have to do with, too, they're coming off that loss to TMSR. The last thing they would want to do that they would expect is to start 0-2 in the group stages, and it just so happens that the Ringers are in their way. So, again, they are, too, playing very, very strong here themselves. The Ringers is doing solid, but it's just obviously not enough, at least so far. It is still earlier on, 12 and a half minutes. I don't think this is going to be that absolute quicker game, no matter what, by any means, but it does look like Alliance is starting to get that train rolling. And again, especially with the lineup that they have and just the Lions play style, that is scary stuff to deal with. Jonas the Fan continuing to increase. 390 gold per minute up here. Ophelia, Hanskin's kind of been quiet, but sort of, but not really. I mean, again, he's the one that pushed those bottom two towers And then on top of that, he's had a couple of pretty clutch heals within these fights. He's farming like a boss, 440 GPM. Jeez. But the tops is actually Fousey at 460, 465 even. So again, he finishes the Energizer, 1600 gold saved up though. So we will get an idea of what he's going to be going for next. But you know, I feel like with the farm, especially on Valkyrie, being more of that right-click threat, I still feel like that Icon of the Goddess could prove to be the best choice here. But
it could certainly be an interesting one, but looks like she is going to go for maybe another kill or two. Kraken going to go for the port out right now, but looks like he will be out of there. Really interesting choice to use the Poison Burst right there from Slither, because the ultimate had already, the port had already gone off. Middle lane, yeah. Though, Breaky, are they going to turn this one
that
around?
That was definitely misplaced. Okay. Nui went to stun, but before he did, Prisoner already threw out the ball and Shannon missed. So yeah. I'm sure they were waiting for the stun first, but he just wanted to go beforehand. Now this might backfire even more. Puppet Master being chased. If he can get that Skeletor King net off, it's going to be close. No, he's just out of range.
He might get it on Tempest. Yep. There it is.
Vestalin's follow up. The Nui coming out. Couple seconds stun the Kraken, and yeah, they just can't pursue that much further. So,
yep. Good call right there from Book with the body block on the arrow, knowing that if that did connect with Tempest, that he was certainly dead. Kraken a little bit tankier and a little bit better position. Didn't have as much to worry about, so just to block that for his ally. And well, now Lion's going to go back to just doing whatever they want to do. I mean, that brand new shiny portal key here on Pestilence could be their way into a new team fight. Maybe one that's going to be in their advantage here. Looks like they will start to make it up top.
Yeah.
And Torture going to place that warp sight, so they got plenty of vision up here now.
Yeah, Kraken already falling back. Of course, Book knows that something's up and has good reason for that. So he's going to fall all the way back to base. As Lions is still going to clean up the resources here, take it away from them, clean up the jungle. They're going to push this top tower now. So as far as the ringers, what they're going to be doing, you see Tempest, he is kind of pushing the bottom lane. Has about 1,000 gold saved up. So yeah, you look at Puppet Master, only 160 GPM. He's got Steam Boots and a Ring of the Teacher. So that start has just been pretty bad, but that does go back to the lane choices from Lions. They set up to win against that Puppet Master. Not only win, but dominate and lock him down. And clearly that continues to be an issue here for the Hellborn team to have to deal with. But this top tower, it's going to be aggressively pushed in. And I don't think they're even going to look to stop it. Firebrand is purchased by Slither. So he is going to go for more of that extra farm, more of that carry presence even. With that build. Again, I was leaning towards the Icon mainly because they have that Valkyrie and even a Pestilence who's farming pretty well. But in the end, you know, Firebrand's obviously just fine too for Slither. So speaking of that though, I wonder why Jonas Afandi is sitting on that one Quake Blade. I assume it was going to be a Firebrand, but it's obviously not yet. It has more than enough gold for that. So maybe a Nullfire here.
Yeah, could certainly be a Nullfire Blade. Definitely one that is quite nice against a Puppet Master, especially with two of those longer duration disables. Could purge that off himself, and Valkyrie ultimate gonna go off right here. They are gonna try to find Kraken, and yeah, gonna be pretty successful with that one. Tsunami charge available right into a tree.
No, oh, that hurts. Yeah, I was gonna say, why didn't he? Oh, he did, didn't he? Yeah, he knocks down the tree on accident. I don't think he was getting away anyway, so just kind of an embarrassment added to that. But Master about to port out. The arrow's gonna hit him though. The 5 second arrow to make sure, not even necessary, probably, but anyways, again, in the end, they get the kill. So the chase is successful from Lion Esports Club. And now they're going to make their way pushing out the bottom lane, at least just push it out here. Maybe even go for Kongor. All right, it looks like they might be heading that direction. Yeah, Ophelia's headed over there. Did I just see a Lightbrand purchase by somebody? Who's purchased a Lightbrand? It's on the courier. I can't actually see who it's bought by, but I assume it's... Was it Valkyrie?
I assume
Valkyrie got it.
It could be, yeah.
Really? Okay, so yeah, he's going to go the Searing Light. He doesn't even finish the Firebrand first. A little interesting style of choice there from Jonas Afan, but...
I mean... One of Valkyrie's biggest drawbacks that people have talked about why she's not been used so much in the past year or two is her problems with mana.
Yeah.
And by going Steam Boots and a Lightbrand, I mean, she's definitely solving a lot of those problems. Going to be able to farm a lot more effectively, doesn't have the natural tools that a lot of other heroes have. And so, Lightbrand could be that, but Pestilence going in right here. Arrow's going to go out, not connecting, but Prisoner is going to go down. And they're still going, Breaky.
Yeah, Prisoner was in an awkward spot the whole time, but we see the follow-up. Oh. Master of Arms just gets annihilated there. Well, let's be honest. All he has is boots, so it's not that surprising. But
boots, yeah, and a beard.
The beard power not coming through there.
Oh, no.
Token of life on Slither. But yeah, that was also awkward once again for Sandrox. He was kind of caught in the ledge. He was having troubles getting out. And then by the time he was finally able to get out, all of a sudden he gets jumped. And obviously we saw the follow-up there, so... In the end, we do have Lion Esports Club easily winning that fight right there. They're going to push the middle tower. And will they stick around for the melee racks? I guess I don't see why not. I mean, Prisoner is going to be up right here. But yeah, they're not really threatened necessarily. I kind of have. I mean, Tempest and Kraken, they do have some wombo combo potential. So yeah, they are going to fall back. Not worth the risk by any means, or are they? Valkyrie Prism, here we go, the fake fallback.
Oh, the smoke gank.
Is it going to be successful is the question. Puppet Master.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. There you go. They find Puppet Master. And nice pull in the counter, actually. Going to be coming out right there. Meanwhile, Pestle's going to be picked up. And now Torture in a bad spot. Release the Kraken. Going to finish him off. The tap is a little bit locking out Slither. He's going to fall down. He does have the token of life. And he should be fine after coming up with that. In fact, there you go. And now you see the helper place fall. And toxicity debuff. So strong. Even in the well. Buybacks are happening, Beef.
They certainly are, Breaky. And it looks like the Hellborn team is going to be able to defend this Rax, as Tempest is going to get turned around upon. Male definitely trying, but not going to happen right there. The Prisoner hook to no avail as well. Ophelia trying to get out of there. Looks like she will get gone. And now the melee Rax are there. Lions are masters of being like, okay, guys, we're out.
Yeah,
bye.
Really.
Just kidding. You're dead.
Yeah, the beautiful turnaround. And again, what better of an ability than a Valkyrie Prism to be able to really catch them off guard. So I think it was kind of a mix. It felt like the Hellborn team, the Ringers, were actually able to somewhat kind of spot that, but then it began and wasn't going to stop. So Dawnbringer is going to be in the works here for Valkyrie. She actually finishes the Searing Light, or at least got the Firebrand. It's on the way being delivered, so has that Searing Light. Slither has 3,500 gold saved up, so we'll see what I assume the Geometer's Bane has enough gold for that. In fact, port it back right there. There you go. There's a Geometer's Bane purchase. Yeah, big, big tier items coming out here for Lion Esports Club. So although the Ringers, they're going to hang in here and hope for anything to happen. But we're now slowly approaching that 20-minute mark. It is a 19,000 gold lead, nearly a 12,000 experience lead. And that is damn hard to overcome, especially when your carry of choice hero is just continuing to struggle. He barely has surpassed that 200 GPM mark. And it just continues to go back to Lions. They addressed him from the beginning, and they have not let up. But hey, that once again, that's typical Lions. That's what they do best. They're doing the same thing here. They're going to clean up the opposing ancients even. And I wouldn't be surprised if they just wait for the next Conqueror now before trying to really finish things off. But they might be going in, though. They're trying to protect their ancients, but by the time they get there, yeah, it's just too late.
Yeah, right now for the Ringers, I mean, it's just kind of coming to terms with the fact that this game is most likely over. I mean, you turtle up into the 70-minute mark, yeah, maybe you might be able to have something happening then when Ophelia starts to, like, maybe not be so effective. But MOA going to go down here one more time. Znui, see you later. Hook trying to bring him back in, but that doesn't work out. And now Tempest getting caught out. Papa Male going down.
You know, it's kind of funny because I was watching the bottom right there. Kraken actually tried to TP out. He put the release of Kraken down on Valkyrie trying to get away. Valkyrie just arrowed him in the face, though, to stop it. And then they were having their own fun down there. But obviously, she's now joined the team. Kraken's still down here like, well, I got no TP now, and my base is being pushed in. So, yeah, this is a really awkward spot to be in. But Lions is going to easily drop another set of racks right here. And I cannot see the Ringers really hanging in too much longer. It's, you know, they got the victory over the Law in the first match, but the Lion Esports Club clearly just too strong for them. Master of Arms going to be picked off right there. The two sets of racks being down. I expect those GG well plays to be in the near future now, Beef.
There would have been a kill right there on Pestilence, but there was a blast shot, and I'm like, oh, okay, this is over. Blast shots are going off. GG well plays are being called, Breaky. And there you go. Lions posts up their first win here as competitors at DreamHack. As it looks like the Ringers going to be falling. There's the big Tempest ult they've been looking for, I guess.
Oh, I know. Stopped immediately. They tried to bait them. They tried the fake CC strat. It almost worked.
Yeah.
Not really. It didn't work. So, yeah, obviously the end result right there. Lion Esports Club, they take the game. And that means now they're 1-1 here in Group B. So, again, their first game, they lost to Too Much Sugar. If you happen to be just tuning in, Too Much Sugar versus Lions. It was a hell of a way to kick off the event, a 60-plus minute match. TMSR did win that one, though. So, again, they're starting off with the 1-0 mark, obviously. So, well, Lions now 1-1. We got the Ringers now 1-1 as well. So, you know, still fairly happy with that, I'm sure. Again, they came into this not really expecting too much in the end.
Yeah.
So, that's got to be a pretty good feeling. But that also means now, well, as far as now things as far as moving on, I believe the plan is, Beef, we're going to be going into a little bit of a break here in between the matches. So
yeah. Yeah, we're definitely going to be going into a more extensive break than the 5 or 10 minutes. Maybe we'll be able to get an interview with somebody before we actually go to that break, or maybe talk to the players or whatnot. I'm sure we'll be able to do something during that break rather than just have a dead stream for a couple hours. But the next match break, yeah, that's not for a while. Not until 17:30, which is about an hour from now. That appears to be when we're looking at the next matches.
So not crazy too long by any means, but yeah, at about an hour, obviously, so it's a break for the players, the cast, and everything, and to go ahead and just get some lunch or whatever time. I don't even know what time it is. Anyways, to do whatever, just take a break, but then we'll be getting back to the match. So like you said, about an hour from now, 17:30 Central European Time. Too Much Sugar versus the Ringers is the match that we do have on the list, actually, to cover right there. And obviously, that's a pretty big matchup because of the Ringers and being 1-1 here. Could you imagine if they beat TMSR all the way? It's kind of like a three-way tie between those three teams.
Yeah.
Out of nowhere. And that would actually be pretty funny to kind of see moving on. But with that said, so not only do we have that match, but then we got even two more matches after that. So we still got three more matches in total for you today here on the DreamHack for the DreamHack Winter 2013 event. And this is just day number one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Once again. So we got into tomorrow, of course, or eventually we'll get into the bracket stage. And then on Saturday is when we get the semifinals that lead up, of course, into the grand finals. And that's going to be a blast, man. That is. So, like you said, I believe we are going to try to maybe grab an interview here real quickly and get into that. But we are going to be going through a short break right here, to say the least. We'll let you know with any updates further than that. Ladies and gentlemen, you're tuning into the DreamHack Winter 2013 coverage. I'm Breaky CBK. This is... there you go.
I'm Beef. Right? Is that my name?
Is that
my line? I don't know.
I tried to steal it from you.
Sometimes.
I shouldn't have done that. We're going on a break. We clearly need it. Anyways, there you go, just in case you forgot. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so stay tuned, though. We'll be back with more DreamHack Winter 2013 coverage.